Dun, dun. Okay, so welcome to Doki Doki Literature Club. So I played a bit of this on my own, and it seems like a normal little game, but supposedly it's not. I've read a lot of Steam comments, and this game hasn't been out for a while, I don't think, but we're gonna try it out for ourselves a bit. A lot of reading to do. So I'm gonna skip through the first parts, I think. Probably gonna skip through the first parts. Hey, I see an annoying girl running towards me. So basically, what's happening here, I really don't know. Well, all I know is that this was the part that I was at, and then I decided to start recording late, because I got sucked into the game. Alright, no promises though, well at least, yeah, I promise this. Okay, here we go. It's a pretty funny game though. Okay, so this is where I am. If you really want to go see that first part, you can go watch other YouTubers do it. There. The school day is as ordinary as ever, and it's over before I know it. Probably need to take this off because it's getting hot. Rest in peace, headphones. After I pack up my things, I stare blankly at the wall, looking for an ounce of emotion, of motivation. Clubs. Sora wants me to check out some clubs. Guess I have no choice but to start with the anime club. That's how I would be. Hello? Sayori? Sayori must have come into the classroom while I was spacing out. I look around and realize that I'm the only one left in the classroom. I thought I'd catch you coming out of the classroom, but I saw you just sitting here and spacing out. So I came in. Honestly, you're even worse than me sometimes. I'm impressed. You don't need to wait up for me if it's going to make you late to your own club. Oh yeah, I forgot. This game is probably about a literature club. And it is, because the game description says that. But it's called Doki Doki Literature Club, so I'm going to join the literature club. Well, I thought you might need some encouragement, so I thought, you know
what?
Well, that you could come to my club.
Sayori?
Yeah?
There's no way I'm going to your club.
Eh? Meanie.
Sayori is vice president of the literature club. And then we're going to join the literature club, and I don't even know what's gonna happen. Lots of amazing adventures. Wait, is the mouse on the screen? I can't tell if it is. Oh, that's gonna... If it is, I'm so sorry. Not that I was ever aware she had an interest in litter.
In fact, I'm 99% sure she only did it because she thought that it would be fun to help her start a new club. Since she was the first one to show interest after the one who proposed the club, she inherited the title Vice President. That said, my interest in literature is guaranteed to be even less.
Probably. Yeah, I'm going to the anime club.
Come on, please! Why do you care so much anyway? Well, I told a club yesterday I would bring in a new member. And Natsuki made cupcakes and everything.
Don't make promises you can't keep. That is 100% sure. True. Never do that. Even if it's for a friend and stuff. Why did I It's disgusting. I don't know why I did that. Yeah, but I did that. But yeah, that is 100% sure. Do not make promises that you can't keep. Like, well, that's obvious, but I just had to put that out for the state of obvious.
I can't tell if Sayori is really that much of an airhead or if she's so cunning as to have planned all of this out. I let out a long sigh. Fine, I'll stop by for a cupcake, okay?
Yes, let's go!
And thus today marks the day I sold my soul for a cupcake. I dejectedly followed Sayori across the school and upstairs, a section of the school I rarely visit, being generally used to the third year for the oh my god. This game is going to be the death of me because, like, this game is going to be the death of me. I can't read all this. This is a lot of text. More than Harry Potter books, that's for sure. But anyways, Sayori, full of energy, swings open the classroom door. Is she gonna knock someone in the head with it? Guess not. Oh, here's the music.
Everyone, the new member is here. I told you, don't call me.
I told you, don't call me a new member. Glance around the room. Welcome to the Literature Club. It's a pleasure meeting you. I don't know what voice to give you, so I'm going to give you this one. Sayori always says nice things about you.
Seriously, you brought a boy?
Okay, so I think that's the voice I'm going to give her, because she seems like that type of girl.
Seriously, you brought a boy? Way to kill the atmosphere. Ah, Spaghetti! What a nice surprise!
I could tell how they're going to be by the way that their facial expressions are, so...
Welcome to the club!
All words escape me in this situation. This club is full of incredibly cute girls!
What are you looking at? If you want to say something, say it!
Sorry. Natsuki. The girl with the sour attitude, whose name is apparently Natsuki, is one I don't recognize. Her small figure makes me think she's probably a first year. She is also the one who made the cupcakes, according to Sayori. This is gonna be the death of me.
You can just ignore when she gets moody.
Probably gonna forget the voices for these by next episode, but.
Sayori says that quietly into my ear,
and then turns back toward the other girls.
Anyway, that is Natsuki, always full of energy, and this is Yuri, the smartest in the club.
Don't say things like that. Yuri, who appears comparably more mature and timid, seems to have a hard time keeping up with people like Sayori and Natsuki. Well, it's nice to meet both of you.
And it sounds like you already know Monica, is that right? That's right. It's great to see you again, Spaghetti.
I don't know if that's the same voice I gave her earlier, but... Monica smiles sweetly. What is that pose? It's just like... Why is this pose a thing? We do know each other well. We rarely talked, but we were in the same class last year. Monica was probably the most popular girl in this class. Smart, beautiful, athletic. Basically, completely out of my league. So having her smile at me so genuinely feels like a little... you too, Monica.
Come sit down, Spaghetti. We made room for you at the table, so you can sit next to me or Monica.
Well, in the background, there's like so many, there's so many things. So many desks. We could just take one of these desks.
I'll get the cupcakes. Hey, I made them. I'll get them. Sorry. I got a little too excited.
go. Leave me alone. I'm playing. Pistol is somewhere else.
Sorry, I got a little too excited.
How about I make some sweet tea, some tea as well? Ah, yes, tea. Tea and crumpets, the two best things. Haven't had crumpets, actually, but tea is pretty good. I like some tea. It's nice. The girls have a few desks arranged to form a table. As Sayori mentioned, it's been widened so that there is one more space next to Monika and one space next to Sayori. Natsuki and Yuri walk over to the corner of the room where Natsuki grabs a wrap tray and Yuri opens the closet. Still feeling awkward, I take a seat next to Sayori. Natsuki proudly marches back to the table, tray in hand.
Okay, are you ready? Ta-da.
Dang it, she went from really mean, like a mean girl, to like this. I don't know what voice to give her.
Oh!
Natsuki lifts the foil off the tray to reveal a dozen white fluffy cupcakes decorated to look like little cats. The whiskers are drawn with icing, and little pieces of chocolate were used to make ears. That's great.
So cute! I had no idea you were so good at baking, Natsuki. It's so kawaii! Well, you know. Just hurry and take one.
Sayori grabs one first, then Monika. I follow.
It's delicious.
Sayori talks with her mouth full and has already managed to get icing on her face, so it'd be like,
it's delicious.
I hate people who chew with their mouth open. Or even talk with when food in their mouth. It just makes me very mad. Oh, I didn't even read that text. Natsuki is quiet. I can't help but notice her sneaking glances in my direction. Is she waiting for me to take a bite? I finally bite down. The icing is sweet and full of flavor. I wonder if she made it herself.
This is really good.
Thank you, Natsuki.
Why are you thanking me? It's not like I...
Haven't I heard this somewhere before?
Made them for you or anything.
I thought you technically did. Sayori said...
Well, maybe. But not for you, you know, dummy.
All right. Jesus, so salty. I give up on Natsuki's weird logic and dismiss the conversation. Yuri returns to the table carrying a tea set. It's a bit late. Well, then again, tea takes a minute to make herself. She carefully places a teacup. That's like a tea, but you get cut by it. Making up my own language now. She carefully places a teacup in front of each of us before sitting down the teapot next to the cupcake tray.
You keep a whole tea set in this classroom? Don't worry, the teachers gave us permission. After all, doesn't a hot cup of tea help you enjoy a good book?
Yeah, but I haven't really ever tried that. I mean, sounds pretty good, but... I guess? This guy's not like me.
Don't let yourself get intimidated.
Intimidated?
Yuri's just trying to impress you.
That's not... Insulted, Yuri looks away.
I meant that, you know...
I believe you. Tea and reading might not be a pastime for me, but I at least get to enjoy tea. I'm glad. Yuri faintly smiles to herself in relief. Monika raises an eyebrow, then smiles at me.
So, what made you consider the literature club?
I was afraid of this question,
Something tells me I shouldn't tell Monica that I was practically dragged here by Sayori.
Well, I haven't joined any clubs yet, and Sayori seemed really happy here, so...
That's okay, don't be embarrassed.
Well, we'll make sure you feel right at home, okay?
Okay. Oh, so I don't have to click, I can just... Oh, so I don't need the mouse on the screen. Okay. That helps a lot.
As president of the Literature Club, it's my duty to make the club fun and exciting for everyone. Except for me, because I don't like literature all that well. Especially poems.
Monica, I'm surprised. How come you decided to start your own club? You could probably be a board member of any of the major clubs.
Weren't you a leader of the debate club last year?
Well, you know, again with the pose. I don't even know what she's doing. It's like, I don't know.
To be honest, I can't stand all of the politics around the major clubs. It feels like nothing but arguing about the budget and publicity and how to prepare for events. I'd much rather take something I personally enjoy and make something special out of it.
Well, that's good. At least she has common sense.
And if it encourages others to get into literature, then I'm fulfilling that dream. Monica really is a great leader.
Yuri also nods in agreement.
And I'm surprised there aren't more people in the club yet. Must be hard to start a new club.
You could put it that way. How many people are very interested in putting out all the effort to start something brand new?
Especially when it's something that doesn't grab your attention, like literature.
That is true.
You have to work hard to convince people that you're both fun and worthwhile.
Okay. Like you two. Yeah, I work hard to do that, and I don't think I work that hard, but I'm gonna try.
But it makes school events like the festival that much more important. I'm confident that we can all really grow this club, before we graduate. Right, everyone?
Yeah!
We'll do our best.
You know it! I don't know what voice to give them. My voice keeps going high-pitched when I try to do Natsuki's voice.
Everyone enthusiastically agrees.
Such different girls all interested in the same goal. Monica must have worked really hard just to find these three. Maybe that's why they're all so delighted by the idea of a new member joining. Though I still don't really know if I can keep up with their level of enthusiasm about literature. So, Spaghetti, what kinds of things do you like to read?
Well, considering how little I've read these past few years, I don't really have a good way of answering that. Manga? I mutter quietly to myself, half-joking. Natsuki's head subtly perks up. It looks like she wants to say something, but she keeps quiet. Oh, she likes manga. Yes, she does. Okay, so we got us a manga girl over here.
Not much of a reader, I guess.
Well, that can change. What am I saying? I spoke without thinking after seeing Yuri's sad smile.
Anyways, what about you, Yuri?
Well, let's see. Yuri traces the rim of her teacup with her finger.
My favorites are usually novels that build deep and complex fantasy worlds. The level of creativity and craftsmanship behind them is amazing to me. And telling a good story in such a foreign way is equally impressive.
Her vocabulary. Phew. I know those words, but when I use them, nope.
Yuri goes on, clearly passionate about her reading. She seems so reserved and timid since the moment I walked in, but it's obvious by the way her eyes light up that she finds comfort in the world of books, not people.
But you know, I like a lot of things.
Stories with deep psychological elements usually immerse me as well. Cute anime girls, like when I walked in.
And anime, I like anime.
Isn't it amazing how a writer can so deliberately take advantage of your own lack of imagination to completely throw you for a loop?
Yeah, that is pretty crazy, because I read a lot of books. It doesn't seem like that, because all I have is... This is empty. No books are here. But I have a French dictionary. Pretty good. But I don't actually have any books in here. But in the other room, there's a bookshelf, and that has a whole bunch of books, because I read a lot of Goosebumps and stuff. And I don't really know the full meaning of literature. I'm pretty sure that that's like poems and stuff, but it's not. It's also books and stuff, but poems are in it, which is why I don't think I'd really be into it. But for like reading books and stuff and reading along with them and talking about the books and stuff and writing like passages and stuff, I feel like I could do that. But poems, nah, I could not be poetic. I would be like, it's a flower. The flower is beautiful. Isn't it amazing? Oh. Anyway, I've been reading a lot of horror lately. Ah, yes, good old horror. I read a horror book once. I desperately grasped something I can relate to at the minimum level. Minimum level. At this rate, Erin might as well be having a conversation with a rock.
Really? I wouldn't have expected that, Erin. For someone as gentle as you, I guess you could say that. But if a story makes me think or takes me to another world, then I really can't put it down. Surreal horror is often very successful at changing the way you look at the world, if only for a brief moment. Kind of, I guess. Ugh, I hate horror. Oh? Why's that? Well, I just... Natsuki's eyes dart over to me for a split second. Never mind. That's right, you usually like to write about cute things, don't you, Natsuki?
What?
What gives you that idea? You left a piece of scrap paper behind the last club meeting. It looked like you were working on a poem called... Don't say it out loud! Don't say it out loud! Or I'm gonna leave this club. Fine, fine. Your cupcakes, your poems, everything you do is just so cute as you are.
Sayori sidles up behind Natsuki and puts her hands on her shoulders.
I'm not cute!
Natsuki, you write your own poems?
Well, I guess sometimes. Why do you care?
I think that's impressive. I can't even write a full sentence by myself. Not sure I can, but... Jokes. Why don't you share them sometime?
No.
Natsuki averts her eyes.
You wouldn't like them.
Says who? She doesn't know me. I've been in here for like 10 minutes or so. Not a very confident writer yet.
I understand how Natsuki feels. Sharing that level of writing takes more than just confidence. The truest form of writing is writing to oneself. You must be willing to open up to your readers, exposing your vulnerabilities, and showing even the deepest reaches of your heart. Do you have writing experience too, Yuri? Maybe if you share some of your work, you can set an example and help Natsuki feel comfortable enough to share hers. I guess it's the same for Yuri.
Aw, I wanted to read everyone's poems.
We all sit in silence for a moment. Okay, I have an idea, everyone. Natsuki and Yuri look quizzically at Monika. Let's all go home and write a poem of our own. Then the next time we meet, we will all share what we wrote with each other. I think that's what it said.
That way everyone is even. Yeah, let's do it!
Okay, so she is like the light bulb in the situation Sayori is.
Plus, now that we have a new member, I think it will help us all get a little more comfortable with each other and strengthen the bond of the club.
Whoa.
I don't think I said I was joining, but
cute anime girls, like you said at the beginning, so.
Isn't that right, Spaghetti? Monica smiles warmly at me once again.
Hold on, there's still one problem.
Huh? What's that? Now that we're back to the original topic of me joining the club, I bluntly come forth what's been on my mind the entire club. I never said I would join this club. Sayori may have convinced me to stop by, but I never made any decision. I still have other clubs to look at, and, I lose my train of thought. All four girls stare back at me with dejected eyes. Oh god, that would peer pressure me so much. But not really peer pressure me, but that would put so much pressure on me that I would probably, one, like, just say yes and be like, okay, let's go home. Or I don't know what I would do. But, I'm sorry, I thought, Spaghetti? You all, I'm defenseless against these girls. How am I supposed to make a clear-headed decision when it's like this? That is, if writing poems is the price I need to pay in order to spend every day with these beautiful anime girls. Right. Okay, I've decided then. I'll join the literature club. One by one, the girls' eyes light up. Okay. Nice.
Yes, I'm so happy!
Suri wraps her arms around me, jumping up and down. Hey! Really did scare me for a moment.
If you really just came for the cupcakes, I would be super mad.
Then that makes it official. Welcome to the literature club. Thanks, I guess. It's an honor. It's like joining the army. Service.
Okay. Okay, everyone. I think with that, we can officially end today's meeting and go on a good note. Everyone remember tonight's assignment? Write a poem to bring the next meeting so we can all share.
Monica looks over at me once more.
Spaghetti, I look forward to seeing how you express yourself.
Oh. I can really impress the class star Monica with my mediocre writing skills. I already feel the anxiety welling up inside me. Meanwhile, the girls continue to chit-chat as Yuri and Natsuki clean up their food.
Hey, Spaghetti, since we were already here, do you want to walk home together?
That's right. Sayori and I never walk home together anymore because she always stayed after school for clubs.
Sure. Might as well. I'm lonely.
Yay!
With that, the two of us depart the club room and make our way home. The whole way, my mind wanders back and forth between the four girls, Sayori, Natsuki, Yuri, and of course, Monica.
Oh, so is this like a game to where I have to choose one?
If I really did have to choose one, I think I would probably go with, I don't know. I'm thinking about Yuri or Natsuki, because Natsuki, it seems like her part of the story would be funnier because she's not really, you could tell that she probably is into me, and she's like, oh, he likes anime too, but she doesn't want to come out to be that type of girl, so she doesn't say anything. Will I really be happy spending every day? I think I will. Perhaps I'll get close. Yeah, so I'm pretty sure we are. I'll just need to make one of my current circumstances, and I'm sure a good version will call me. And then, okay, so I gotta, what are these for? Pick words you think your favorite club member will like. Something good might happen to whoever likes your poem the most. Okay.
What? No, I'm eating.
Okay, I'll choose the poem. I think I'm going to have to go with Yuri. Yeah, I think, you know what, Natsuki, I'm going with Natsuki. Okay, so she likes cute little things, so chocolate? Yeah, she likes that. Clouds? Okay. Vivid, wrath, headphones, vanilla.
Giggle. Okay, I'm doing it. Joy. What? Sayori likes that? Oh, okay. Kawaii! Okay, so I get what she... Games. Games? Yeah. Okay, kitty. Candy. Okay, so I know what she likes now. Anime. Bunny. So she likes any, like, animals and stuff. A puppy. We gotta do 20 of these? Okay. Well, let's pray that I get her, because I got one mom, but I don't think that'll matter. Embrace shopping. Milk depression. That'd probably be Sayori. She seems like that type of girl. Ugh. Oh, dang it, she likes that. Darky, darky. Huh. I don't know. Papa. Bubbles. Okay, three more. Little Inferno. Kiss, and two more, so, dang it, she liked that, lollipop, okay, one more, oh, dang it, let's pray that I get her. Hi again, Spaghetti. Okay, I think I'm gonna leave this episode here, and we will find out what she thinks about my poem tomorrow, so, save, and empty slot. Okay. So, yeah. I think that sums it up for this video, which is great. So, thank you guys so much for watching. And if you like this video, punch that like button in the face, but don't break your screen. And see you in the next video, which I don't know what it will be, but this will come out soon. So, hope you guys like it, and I'll see all you guys in the next video.